She was a flower for the taking. Her beauty cut just like a knife. And he was a banker for making. He swore to love her all his life. He bought her a mansion on a mountain with a formal garden and a lot of land. The paradise became her prison. Bad Georgia banker was a jealous man. Every time he talked about her, you could see the fire in his eyes. He'd say, I would walk through hell.
So you did not have to make too many adjustments on that shoe.
Let's only make one more.
What are you looking for when you're making adjustments?
Mainly I'm lining the nail holes up with a white line to get a nice nail bite. You know, when I'm not inside of it, I'm not too far outside of it.
Seems like a lot of guys have trouble shaping those shoes. Why do they have so much trouble with that?
I think the main thing is guys get to doing shortcuts. And the benefit to having a shoe that's sort of semi-square is that you have a wider breakover point and you have a shorter breakover point. And the shoes, when they come from the box, are more angular, more pointed, and if you follow that point, you'll stretch that whole capsule. It'll just keep stretching and stretching, and the horse will have that lever that we talked about earlier sticking out in front of it, causing a problem.
So the horse's foot then will actually grow to the shoe? Is that what you're saying?
You definitely can correct directly manner in which a horse's foot grows by your fitment of shoes. You know.
So when you're looking down, what are you looking for?
I'm just looking at overall symmetry of the foot, making sure I don't have any real big flares, making sure the foot's sitting pretty square underneath the leg, making sure I have enough expansion room so that the foot can expand over the next 8-week period and he doesn't grow over his shoes in the first week or two. Making sure that you know, the toe's short enough. If you look through the shoe and the foot marry up with each other, there's no big gaps or anything, so it's a nice even pressure all the way around. And if you look in here, you can slide my fingernail all the way around the inside of this web and know that I don't have any undue sole pressure. So if the horse is bearing weight, only the spots that he needs to...
Hand on that thought you just said there for my understanding. So your fingernail goes down there, you're looking to see there's no gap, so you know that it's evenly bearing weight.
Well, on the inside, on the outside, you want pretty much nice, even displacement of weight. See, if you look at this from the side, there's no gaps. You couldn't slide anything in there.
Right.
So that means I got the foot pretty flat, I got the shoe pretty flat, I got everything pretty flat. really, at this point, should be almost able to. He had a little bit of a toe flare since he was so long. So there's a little bit to be dressed off of here. But basically, I'm not going to dress anything really off the sides. That's pretty much where it is. This is pretty much where it is on the inside. So I'm going to take a little bit under here and just dress this dorsal wall back just a little bit. Because not always can you take all your length of your toe from the bottom without over thinning your sole. So the object is you want from this apex of the frog here, this point of the frog, you want to shorten this breakover up. And if you can you hand me that other shoe?
Yeah.
Let me have one.
Is it?
Yeah. This is what they start off looking like. So if I would have just took this shoe and nailed it on there, I'd have another 3/4 of an inch of toe sticking out there. Well, we don't want that. That's not optimum for the horse. So we square or round this part out in order to make it to shorten his breakover. And like I was saying before, this portion of the foot, see, I can slide my fingernail all the way underneath the web of this, the inside web of this shoe, because I've took the round part of my hammer and beat the inside web of the shoe up. And if you look at this part, there's no gaps here, so it's basically all your pressures on this outside.
That's a pretty well fit shoe. You know, no big gaps, nice short breakover. You could fit this horse a little fuller if you want to. I'm not going to because he's got a nice upright foot. He's got enough shoe back here for support. But you could, if you want to, go with one size larger shoe, and depending on the horse's conformation or what he's doing for a living, I might make that choice. You know, this horse is a little Arab horse who probably has a big extended trot. He might even break one of those shoes off if you tried to fit him too full. And I'm going to turn him around now.
Okay.
And the first thing you do when you pick up a foot like this that's really, really long, is you start thinking in your mind, all right, what is this foot supposed to look like? I have a little bit of a clue because I just did the other one, but you still have to have that picture of what you're kind of going for in your mind. And sometimes, like for me, sometimes I'll do horses for years and years and maybe problem feet, problem conformation, problem this or that, and I'll have that picture in my mind till I get it, and I might not get it for quite a while. I might have to just keep working on it, keep striving towards what I want, and sometimes you never get it, but you still keep trying to improve all the time. And the same thing when I get this cleaned out a little bit. I'll make a little reference mark there just to kind of give an idea of where I'm shooting for versus where he's at. And what I kind of do is I look at the apex and somewhere, you know, from an inch and an eighth to an inch and a half is where I'm going to be looking to get that breakover point, depending on how big the horse is and how much he weighs. So when you look at that, you say, wow, man, that's a lot of foot. That's a whole lot of foot. And I do it a couple different ways. Sometimes I'll get in here and I'll know I'm taking a lot of toe off, and I'll just start cutting toe.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Some guys don't do that. Some guys will start at the heels and work their way around. Some guys, if they got a heel that's higher, they always start on the higher heel and blend their foot out to bring it into balance. You know, I know all those tricks, and just depending on what my mood is, will be how I do it. You know, this horse, I know I got a lot of foot, so I got plenty of room to play around before I'm anywhere near where he's gonna be. And basically, when I get to this side, I'm gonna basically have most of my work done.
So what happens, like, on a horse where you have the heels that don't match or a club foot?
You always try to picture in your mind what would be best for the horse and work towards it. So if he's got a no-heel, high-heel situation, you take the high heel as close to perfect as you can get, and you take as much toe off the no-heel to get it as close to the other foot, so you try to work towards having a match, even if you never actually get it perfectly right. You're going to get him a heck of a lot closer than the way he's going, thus you're going to have some improvement. But like I said, you know, after doing this a long time, the major rules for shoeing are short toe and level, medial laterally, so side to side. And, you know, so now just talking about, you know, if I was in a hurry and didn't want to take the time to make this shoe proper, you know, you look at this, right, you put this on this foot and you go, okay, I can kind of get in there. I could go over there and hit this one time on the toe, and I could nail this shoe on this foot. But that wouldn't do nothing for helping his break over. And, you know, it would do nothing for backing his foot up.
And people like to throw that term around, backing the foot up, all the time. And what that means is you're backing up your break over, which is basically from here to wherever it's going to break over to. Because when you stretch that capsule, this could be out to here. And then that's acting like a lever every time that horse steps over it.
As you said, that sometimes it takes a while before the hoof has the look that you have in your mind.